How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys three of the best VPNs that you could use. And of course, I'm going to show you how you can use a VPN on your desktop. No matter which VPN you decide to go for, using a VPN is really not that difficult. If you're new to VPNs, it's as simple as just clicking an on and off button. But of course, you want to learn a little bit more about the VPN and what the functions are for. And today, after having tested a couple of dozen VPNs, I've narrowed it down to these three so that you can make a good choice here, no matter which one you go for. These are top three VPNs. These are top tier VPNs. No matter which one you go for, you'll be able to fulfill your VPN needs no matter which one you go for. Whether you're looking for a premium service or a budget service, you'll be able to find something for you here, okay? So before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs with regards to their privacy policies, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features, okay? Now, with ExpressVPN, I'm gonna go ahead and teach you using ExpressVPN, and you'll see how that will translate to all the other VPNs very easily, okay? So let's talk about ExpressVPN. I'll talk about the couple of features that are available with ExpressVPN, and of course, there are bonus features that you'll find with NordVPN and Surfshark, but if you're interested in learning a little bit more about them, again, you'll find everything you need in the reviews below. So with ExpressVPN, let's just go with that. It really is as simple as just turning an on and off button. And with the other VPNs, you see the connect button right here. It will connect you to a random, not really random, but it's what the VPN thinks is the best location for you. So ExpressVPN shows the smart location here. It thinks that the German Frankfurt 1 server is the best choice for me. But of course, it really depends on what you're looking for. So if you wanna, let's say, connect to a US server because you're trying to unblock Hulu or Amazon Prime or Netflix US, you want to go to VPN locations, pick Americas, United States, and pick one of these servers. Okay, so it's as simple as that. And of course, with NordVPN and Surfshark, it extends to, you know, with NordVPN, you can just zoom in here, or with Surfshark, you can just look it up on the search bar or the search bar of NordVPN or the search bar of ExpressVPN if you don't want to click around. So or you can just scroll down, for example, here. You can also scroll down with NordVPN and just pick one of the servers available. Let's say Atlanta right here, and just select one of these. Okay, so it's as simple as that. Or you can just zoom in here and pick one of the states, for example. So as you can tell, with regards to picking the location, it's very easy. Now, you might get a little bit confused when you go to the options. Now, all you need to know, really, basically, is that you have the protocols tab and the general tab. In most VPNs, that's all you want to mess with, really. For the most part, that's all you need to know. The kill switch will stop your internet access if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, making sure that you don't get any information leaked if the VPN disconnects for whatever reason, which is unlikely to be the case with these VPNs. But if the VPN does disconnect, it will disconnect your internet access as well. Split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So you can choose, for example, a specific application here, such as your torrenting client and Google Chrome. Let's say you're streaming on Google Chrome and downloading a torrent. You can choose these two applications. And when you turn on the VPN, it will only route these two applications through the VPN, leaving the rest of your connection untouched by the VPN tunnel. So this is a very useful feature, which is also available in NordVPN and Surfshark. So right here, split tunneling, the kill switch, and you have the generals tab, which has an ad blocker. And here you have the protocol options. You have the kill switch, as well as an app kill switch, which are close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops, rather than disconnecting your entire connection as it is with the conventional kill switch. Again, split tunneling, just like ExpressVPN, very easy to use. You can choose which applications. And in advance, you have an easy way to change your DNS with custom DNS and obfuscated servers if you're in a censorship-heavy country, but you don't really need to use them for the most part, okay? You have over 3,200 servers with ExpressVPN. over 5,400 servers in 60 countries with NordVPN, and over 3,200 servers in 65 countries with Surfshark. Okay, you'll be able to secure up to 5 devices per subscription with Express, 6 with Nord, and an unlimited number with Surfshark, making it a great VPN if you want to share your account around with as many people as you would like. And by the way, with regards to protocols, you don't really need to mess with them. You can set it on automatic on all the VPNs and you'll be good to go. But I just like to choose the fastest one, which is going to be lightweight UDP with Express VPN. And in advance, you have nothing to worry about here unless you want to opt out sharing crash reports. But this does not contain any personally identifiable information, so no worries there. With browsers here, you can download some browser extensions and shortcuts. We'll give you all these shortcuts. So if you notice here, when I turn on the VPN, you'll notice these shortcuts showing up. Okay, and if you want to double check that you are indeed connected to the IP address that you or the country that you chose here, just go to any IP finder and it will tell you that yes, you are connected indeed to the UK, right? So if I disconnect here, let's say you chose NordVPN, okay, for whatever reason, maybe you like the interface, maybe you like the extra features that it comes with, you know, specialty servers and ad blocker and whatnot. You can zoom in here. So you saw how I used ExpressVPN. Just go to the list and pick one of these servers. With NordVPN, you have that option of going through the list, but you also have the option to go through each server individually rather than it just being locations as it is with ExpressVPN and Surfshark. With NordVPN, you can, let's say, select a state here. You can go through every single server individually. With ExpressVPN and NordVPN, it will select the server for you. You can just pick the location. But with NordVPN, you can just browse through these servers manually, or you can just zoom in here and pick one of these servers. Let's just go with New York, for example, the New York location, and it will pick a server depending on what it thinks is the best for me, okay? Zoom out, go to the IP finder, double check that you're connected to that location, and we are in New York as far as Google Chrome is concerned, or my entire network, really. So it really is as simple as that. And of course, it's the same thing with Surfshark. Just go to one of these and connect. So again, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. It really is as simple as it gets when it comes to using a VPN. There's nothing complicated about it. And all these VPNs do have a 30-day money-back guarantee. So it's very risk-free if you want to try out these VPNs for 30 days. That'll be it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel. Stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.